Welcome everyone. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about the Felkin-Anh model. And if you are someone who is absolutely confused about the fact that sometimes you find the Felkin-Anh model written like that, and sometimes you see that in the books, it is written in this form. So if you watch this whole video, this entire confusion is going to be cleared that why do we sometimes use this conformation and why do we use this conformation. So in this video we are going to absolutely learn the very basic of Felkin-Anh model, and after watching this video I'm sure you're going to crack all the questions that are based on this particular problem. Okay, so first of all, let us understand why do we need the Felkin-Anh model. Okay, so what was observed when carbonyl compounds having a chiral center at the alpha position, or in some cases we don't have the chiral center, so when you carry out a reaction on the carbonyl compound, what was observed that there was an asymmetric induction on this center, as a result of which we get a diastereoselectivity. And diastereoselectivity means we get one of the diastereomer major as compared to the other. So this was something which was quite striking. Now let us look at the other example. In this case, the ethyl grignard was attacked on aldehyde, and if we see that in this case we are getting this alcohol major, whereas in this case we are getting this major, and the diastereoselectivity is completely reversed. Here this is the major, and here in this case this is major. So there has to be a model which can explain this asymmetric induction or this diastereoselectivity. That is when Felkin-Anh model was proposed. Felkin-Anh was the guy who proposed this model, keeping into consideration various steric factor around the carbonyl group and the approach of nucleophiles, as a result of which we can, you know, absolutely predict the absolute diastereoselectivity, which one is going to be the major compound. Okay, now let us look at what he said. If we have a carbonyl compound, and let us suppose if we have a three functional group that are attached, the large group could be, you know, like groups like phenyl group or TBDMS group, or a medium sized group like methyl group. So we need to all this numbering is going to be the relative in terms of groups that are present on the molecule, and the smaller groups could be something like hydrogen. So what he said that if we can somehow, you know, write it in the form of the Newman projection, then we can predict the approach of a nucleophile. Not just try and write it like this form, R dash and RL, RS, RM. Okay, so what he said that the largest group that is present, it has to be perpendicular to the carbonyl. It means this largest group is perpendicular to the carbonyl, so the angle between the carbonyl and the largest group is 90 degrees, and the medium size group has to be on this side, and the smallest group must be opposite to the functional group that is attached to the carbonyl in order to reduce the steric interaction. Imagine if our medium sized group is here, there will be a steric interaction between these group, as a result of which it will reduce the stability of the conformer. So this is more or less what was proposed by him. Apart from that, he also said that in such cases the approach of the nucleophile will always take place from the unhindered side. So if we say this is the most unhindered side, that is the approach from the smallest group. So once it approaches and attacks this carbonyl group, then it gives rise to the product. And also it was predicted it was predicted by the Burgi and Duniz. They were the scientists who worked on this, and they said that the approach of the nucleophile is not 90 degree or some random angle. It takes an angle of 107 degrees. The nucleophile approaches the carbonyl at an angle of 107 degrees. And this was predicted by the scientist called Burgi Duniz. So this is also called Burgi Duniz angle. Okay. So once the nucleophile attack, then we can simply convert this into the, we get the Newman projection, which can be converted into the wedge draw structure. Okay, now we are going to first of all take up this example, and then we are going to draw the appropriate Felkin-Anh model and see what could be the product. Okay, so let us start with this example and just try to predict the Felkin-Anh model, what would be the model in this particular case. Okay, so what is the starting point? The first thing that you have to understand is that we have something like this one. So what generally I do is I usually convert this into a Shawhurst conformation, which absolutely eases a lot of problems for me. So if I can convert this into a Shawhurst conformation, then I understand that this is phenyl group is in the plane, and I know methyl group, since this is beta, so this is coming out of the plane, and hydrogen, it is going to the backside. And on behind we have this carbonyl and it has this ethyl group. Okay, now what do we want? We want to project it like that. Means we want to bring this into the front. We want to bring the carbonyl into the front and this into the back. So there are two ways of looking at it. Either I can just, as a viewer, I can look it from this side, or I can look it from this side. But generally what I prefer is to rotate this entire molecule. So what I can do, I can simply rotate this. I can simply rotate it by like that. So if I carry out a rotation, so what happens, you can clearly see, then the position of the phenyl is going to remain as such. Whereas since I have rotated it, the methyl group, which was beta, it is going to go in the backside. Okay, so this is what happens. Now what I need to do is to simply convert this into a Newman projection. This is what I need to do. So simply just convert this into a Newman projection. Ethyl, and we have phenyl group at the backside. And since this methyl is on the left hand side, so this is going to be on the left hand side, and we have a hydrogen here. Okay, so this is what we get. This is the Newman projection. We converted this into the Newman projection. So how can we convert this particular compound into the most stable conformer, or most stable conformer as per the Felkin-Anh model? So if we see, this is the largest group, and this is the medium sized group, and this is the smallest group, and we know that this has to be perpendicular to the carbonyl, and this methyl group, this has to be away from the ethyl group, so this needs to come here. So what operation do we need to perform? So we need to just simply rotate this phenyl group in the clockwise direction. This is what we need to do, and similarly we have to rotate this, and this will undergo rotation as well. So what happens as a result of the rotation? So we have ethyl. Now as a result of the rotation, the phenyl group has come here, and we have the ethyl group, and similarly the hydrogen group has come at this side. So this is how you can easily generate the most stable conformer for Felkin-Anh model. So this is the most stable conformer that you generate, which is absolutely true for this particular molecule. Now after that, we are also going to look at, when I'm going to just simply convert this into the alpha phase, how does this vary? Okay, now what happens, now you have lithium aluminium hydride, which is AlH3 hydride. What we said, it attacks on the least hindered side, which is this one. So it attacks and it goes like that. So what do we get is, here is this OH here, and here we get is an ethyl here, and here what we have is a hydrogen, and on the back side what we have is a phenyl group here, and we have a ethyl here, and what we have is a hydrogen at this position. Okay, so now what do we need to do is to convert this into a, redraw this into a solid wedge structure. So there are many ways that you can do it. So one way to do it, how do I do it, is simply I since the longest chain is ethyl and the phenyl group, so what I'll try to do is to bring these ethyl and phenyl group absolutely on anti to each other. So what we can do, we can just simply write this as hydrogen. What I have done, I have rotated this hydrogen here. OH will come a little down and ethyl will come here. And similarly, what I did, I can rotate the phenyl group in this direction. Okay, if the phenyl group goes here, then we have a ethyl group here. So the ethyl group will come here and we have a hydrogen here. Okay, so this can be simply represented into the wedge dash form like that. So since we have a ethyl here, we have a phenyl group here. Okay, so to the right hand side of the ethyl group, what do we have is the OH. So it means this is solid. Okay, and on the left hand side is what we have is the ethyl group. So this is going to, since this is on the left hand side, this is going to be like that one. Okay, so this is the major product as per the reaction. So this is what we get. So let's just check. So from here itself, we can easily make out that in the major product, that between ethyl and OH, they are anti. This is exactly what happens. If we can just simply, we can write it in that form as well. If we take a mirror image of this one, so what will we get is this. This is what we will get. We will get phenyl here. We will get ethyl here. And in the mirror image, we are going to have, since this is alpha, this is going to become beta. So this is beta, this is going to become alpha. This is exactly what is there in the major product. This is just a simple representation. These are many of the one of many ways by which you can simply represent it. Okay, this was the case when we have methyl group which is beta. When methyl was beta, this was the most stable conformer. This is how we can go about doing it. Now let us suppose, if what will be the product of the reaction? Will the product of the reaction change? I'm going to keep this as such because this is going to be very, very helpful in terms of comparison. So what I'm doing now is to just simply change this into, let's forget about here. Let's not assign a stereochemistry here so far. Okay, then we will understand from the Felkin-Anh model, which is one is going to be the major product. Now let us just simply, I'm going to write this as alpha. This is what we know is alpha. This is something we know is alpha. Okay, let us not assign a stereochemistry here, which is what we are going to do afterwards. Okay, now the same operation we are going to do, how to predict which one is going to be the major diastereomer. This is exactly what we are going to do, which we did previously. First of all, what we do, convert this into a Shawhurst conformation. We know this is in the plane, so we have a phenyl here, and since this methyl is, what is it? It is alpha. This is going behind the plane, so this is going to be on the left hand side. Previously it was on the right hand side, and on the back hand side what we have is a carbonyl and it has a ethyl group. Now what do we need to do? We need to bring it to the front side. So what I did, I simply rotated this one. Rotate it like that. As a result of the rotation, what you have, phenyl group like that, and the position of the methyl group is going to be on the right hand side. Now I can simply represent this in the form of the Newman projection. This is what we do. Now we have this ethyl. Now behind this carbonyl, I'm as a viewer, I'm viewing from this side. So if I view from this side, I have a carbonyl and behind this I have a phenyl group, and on the left hand side I have a hydrogen and on the right hand side I have a methyl group. Okay, now in order to convert this into the most stable conformer, what do I need to do? If in this case, if I carry out a rotation, let us suppose if I rotate this clockwise, this is clockwise rotation. Okay, so the conformer that I get as a result of which this is clockwise rotation, we have a phenyl here, we have a methyl here, we have a hydrogen here. This is clockwise. And if I do it anti-clockwise, okay, all these are anti-clockwise. This is anti-clock. So we have a phenyl here, okay? As a result of the anti-clockwise, now methyl is going to be here and hydrogen is going to be the here. Now you yourself can simply make out which one is the most stable conformation. What we said, the lowest group, that the smallest group has to be here. But here this is the medium size group. So this conformer is not going to form. It is this which is the most stable conformation in this case. So we can clearly see in the previous case it was this which was the most stable conformation. Okay, and here it is this which is the most stable conformation. Now we can easily understand why in certain books sometimes it is phenyl, it is written like that, and why in some cases it is written like that. This is just to get the most stable conformation based on the stereochemistry of the carbon that is at the, which is alpha to the carbonyl. Now let us imagine what happens. Now you can simply clearly make out, if we have an hydride here, it will attack from the least hindered side. Okay, so this is what is going to happen. I hope this was absolutely clear and you are able to understand it, and this is, you are going to crack it absolutely, you know, 100% from here onwards. So this is what happens. So we have OH here and we have ethyl group that is attached to it. We have hydride, and on behind what we have? We have a methyl here, we have a phenyl here, and with phenyl we have a hydrogen here. Absolutely similar technique that we are going to use. What do we want? We want to bring this entire thing into the plane. This is what we want to do. How can we do that? So what do we need to do is to simply bring this groups like that. Ethyl we have, OH we have, okay, this is ethyl, it is attached to OH and hydrogen. And now what do we need to do? We need to just rotate this phenyl to bring it on the top. When methyl, phenyl is rotated onto the top. Now with phenyl we have a methyl group and we have a hydrogen. So hydrogen will come here and methyls will come here. Absolutely similarly, if we convert this into a solid wedge structure, what are going to get? Ethyl, phenyl. Since ethyl, since ethyl is attached to OH, so it is going to be alpha, since it is on the left hand side, and to the phenyl, methyl group is on the right hand side, so this is going to be this. So what is the major product of this reaction? The major product, okay, since we know the stereochemistry of this, so what do we need to do? We need to simply just take the mirror image of this one. So if we take the mirror image of this one, just let's take the mirror image of this one. This is the reason being because here the phenyl is beta. If we take the mirror image of this one, if we take the mirror image, so methyl is going to be like that and this is going to become OH and this is going to be, all right. So we know for sure in this case this is the major diastereomer and this is the minor diastereomer that is going to be the form. So that is how, on the basis of what stereochemistry is present, you have to, you know, come up with the appropriate Felkin-Anh model. Now one more thing, let us suppose if I am not given with any stereochemistry at this center. Let us suppose we are not given with any stereochemistry at this center. Here, not specified. Stereo, not specified. So in that case, it is entirely up to you. In that case, both these models, they are absolutely fine. Phenyl, let's slide this methyl. Both of them are correct if the stereochemistry at alpha position is not specified. But if the stereochemistry is specified, then I have already told you how to go about, you know, getting the correct Felkin-Anh model. Okay, so this was about the Felkin-Anh model. I hope you have learned a whole lot of, you know, deal from this video about how to get the correct conformer for Felkin-Anh. Thanks a lot for watching the video. I'll come up with more interesting video. Have a nice day.